Hello again, Duke of the Bump, back with more Let's Play Popful Mail. In the last episode, we began our quest to find the wizard Muttonhead, so we can capture him and collect the bounty. And then we met a rather pathetic fellow up in a tree named Slick. And I know Popful Mail said she was going to just ignore him, but let's go pay him a visit anyway. I'm feeling generous.
Please, you just gotta take me with you. Hey, I'll even pay you,
Mail, Popful Mail. So, you're gonna pay me to make a man out of you, huh? I'm a little too busy, and you sound like a lot of trouble. If I did consider taking you with me, it'd cost you like 2 million.
2 million? Are we talking gold here? Who do you think I am, Slicky Warbucks?
Can't afford me? Tough break, kiddo.
Listen, if you're not gonna take me with you, and by the way, I think that's a big mistake, could you please tell the villagers where I am? It's the least you can do.
Oh, all right. Whiner.
He really is a whiner. So, a little information about this game. It is, as you can see, a 2D platformer. If I were to sum up the nature of this game in one word, that word would probably be difficult. Although it might not look like it right at the beginning, this game is actually extremely difficult. Your life bar is represented as a meter from 0 to 100. And that's all well and good, except that later on in the game, pretty much every enemy deals between 30 and 45 damage to you. In addition, it's also, you know how in most games there's a little bit of invulnerability time when you get hit? This game doesn't have that. I mean, it flashes for just a second, but it's not really enough. Which makes it really easy to die in this game in the blink of an eye. If you're not careful, you might notice that I tend to be cautious, and if you just rush head on into things, you know, I mean, if I hadn't been paying attention, I could have run right into that spider, and it could have killed me pretty much instantly. I mean, not instantly, but... we have an ambush zone coming up. But, although it's challenging, the game is quite beatable. I have beaten it once before. I'm not an expert at the game or anything, but I enjoyed it a lot, and I thought I would like to share it with people. The game has really impressive music and graphics. I think so, anyway. Some of the best graphics I've ever seen on, in a 16-bit game. Excellent art style. Those green things that those spiders are dropping are medicinal herbs. Each one heals 5 points of damage. And of course the money bags are gold, which we can use to buy items. Let's take a look at the item screen right now. Right now all we have is a short sword, an apple, 2 apples, and an elixir, which will resurrect us once we die. Elixirs in this game are extremely hard to come by. They don't even sell them in shops until the very last area of the game, and even then they cost 10,000 gold apiece, so don't expect to find a lot of elixirs. And once you die, that's it. There are no lives, there are no continues. It just starts you back at the last point that you saved. On the plus side, you can save and load your game pretty much anytime you want. Which makes it, let's just say the game would be impossible if you couldn't save and load the game. Elf Mountain, watch for falling rocks. That looks nice. Can't get up there from here though. It's a fairly linear game. There's not a whole lot of exploration or puzzle solving or oops, or anything like that. God damn it. God, stop dropping shit on me. As you can see, well, can't jump from there. As you can see, I'm already down to 40 health. And unless you use a healing item, like an apple, which only heals like 60% of your health, you have to wait until you get to a town. And once you're there, they actually charge you to heal. 1 gold for every point of life that you need healed. So yeah, the game definitely doesn't pull any punches. And to be honest, I'm probably going to be dying a lot. And I'm going to try to cut the dying down to a minimum, of course. And if it gets really ridiculous, I'll do some editing to cut some of that stuff out. The enemies in this game are pretty diverse, too. I don't want to go in there yet. There are no palette swaps or anything like that. Every enemy is unique, and for the most part, they all have unique patterns, which is nice. Really, the only reason I need to be up here at this point in the game is so I can try to get that chest. Oh, damn it! I bounced off the screen. Oh well, screw it. Let's see if we can find that elf village and see if we can get somebody to... Oops, there's a guy up there. See if we can get somebody to help Slick. I think these guards are a cutscene.
Another Slick caper, eh? What has he done this time? Just the facts, ma'am.
Well, let's see. Monsters chased him up a tree. Now the dumb kid's too scared to come down, and he's waiting for your help.
Sounds like a second story job. We'll take it from here, ma'am.
I don't know what a second story job is supposed to be. I guess they call it that because they have to go up to the second level. I don't know. This is the shop. Let's go ahead and heal what we've taken so far, 60 points. They sell amulets. What these do is, for a limited time, they provide invulnerability, but you can't attack anything while you're using it. But you can equip it and unequip it as many times as you want. So, and it's like the meter runs out while you're using it, but if you don't have it equipped, then it doesn't run out. So it can be pretty helpful in some situations, and especially bosses. And oranges and cherries both heal you. Let's not get any of these at the moment. See what the random townsfolk have to say. Yeah, I did. And he was a crybaby. I see his reputation precedes him. This whole game is crawling with monsters. Everything. Except for the towns. Boy, some soldiers you guys are. I'd say. Alright, anybody down here? No. It's another shop here, the weapon shop. Let's see what they offer. Short sword, that's what we have. Leather mail and a wood shield. Yeah, the game doesn't even start you out with armor or shields. You have to buy those yourself. Even though it looks like you have a shield, that's just it blocks projectiles in the game, and the shield that you can buy increases your defense. Right now, our offense is 20, our defense is 10. Let's go ahead and equip the leather mail. Equip the leather mail on Popful mail. And that gives us a little boost to defense. Of course, even when you have the best armor possible equipped, you still get your ass kicked in this game. I mean, even with the best stuff at the very end of the game, the monsters that you run into still totally kick your ass. Doing pretty well so far. Haven't taken much damage. Oh.
Well, hi! What brings you here, stranger?
I'm Mail. Popful Mail. You see, I'm looking for a magician called Muttonhead. There's a bounty of 2 million gold on his head.
Oh, well, you're on the right path, because I saw that rotten gingerbread grifter gang pass this way. They're in league with Muttonhead, you know.
What? They were here and you let them get away? Where are they? Which way did they go?
Calm down, Male. I'm after those crooks, too. By the way, I'm Namo. If you happen to find them, let me know, and I'll help you nab them.
Oh, sure. And let you get the reward. Nice try, Haystack.
Well, I'll tell you, Bounty Hunter, I'm very strong. Just keep me in mind, okay?
I don't think you ever see that guy again. Alright, that about does it for this episode of Let's Play Popful Mail. I'm Duke of the Bone, and I will see you again tomorrow. Same Popful time, same Popful channel.